This is the Cable Music Network, Stereo 93. This is WYZZ, WYZZ, Wilkes-Barre, Scranton, and Hazleton, your station for beautiful all-time hits. Following UPI News and Be Still and Know, you'll be hearing more great music from people like the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, the Statler Brothers, Bing Crosby and Louis Armstrong, and also music from Ferranti and Teicher, and some special music in honor of St. David's Day. It's time now for news from United Press International. I'm Mark Zimmerman. Nicaraguan President Daniel Ortega says he'd like to talk with U.S. Secretary of State Schultz Friday when they're both in Uruguay for its presidential inauguration. Schultz says he'd like a meeting too, but nothing's been set. Streets in the Uruguayan capital have taken on a festive atmosphere as the nation celebrates a return to civilian rule. After nearly 12 years of military rule, a civilian president will be sworn in Friday. U.S. arms negotiator Paul Nitze says he's optimistic about the outcome of upcoming arms talks with the Soviet Union, but he insists the United States is going into the session in Geneva with its eyes open. Officials in Providence, Rhode Island say federal agents are seeking two more crew members of a leaky Panamanian cargo ship seized Thursday with 15 tons of marijuana hidden under frozen shark meat. Agents have already detained six crew members. In state news, Congressman John Murtha of Johnstown is angry over the continued high levels of steel imports from Japan. Murtha says Japan is waging industrial aggression against the United States and against World War II veterans and their sons who are being put out of work in the steel and related industries. He called for a meeting with President Reagan. Mayor Joseph Battle of Chester packs a pistol and calls criminals dirtballs. Battle does not mince words when he explains where he stands and where he aims to go. These days, his direction is on a collision course with drug dealers. Battle has put a $1,000 price tag on the heads of vandals who shot up the car of a narcotics officer and left a note warning, "Quit messing with us or you're dead." Careless smoking is blamed for a Philadelphia house fire in which three men and one woman died. The bodies of two victims were found in an upstairs middle bedroom, and two others were found at the head of the stairs. It's not known which of the victims had discarded the cigarette that started the fire. And it was on this date in 1781 the American colonies adopted the Articles of Confederation, paving the way for a federal union. That's news. The time is now 1:01.
The Upper Room Devotional Guide presents a moment to be still and know.
Once again, the Lord has that scripture verse is from the book of John. It's free.
There was a marvelous life. A second chance, a chance to do better. Jonah had already disobeyed the Lord. By running away, he had brought harm on himself and put others a second time. And Jonah went on to God's plan. Happily for us, God treats us in the same way. Like Jonah, we have disobeyed by closing our ears to God's voice and breaking God's commandments. Yet God, in mercy, does not cast us off. God's word comes to us again and again. By the providence of God, disobedience and failure need not be the end. It was not so for David, Jonah, Peter, and many others. It need not be so for us either.
William Macmillan from Scotland was the writer for today. Now, our prayer. Lord God, do not forsake us, even when we forsake you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The thought for the day. The gospel of Jesus Christ is the gospel of the second chance.
The time is now 1:03 on this early Friday morning, and the following program of Welsh music in honor of St. David's Day is presented with the best wishes of WYZZ. Now sit back and enjoy some of the world's finest Welsh music.